I think I made my blue too dark. I probably should have looked at some pictures before I started to paint, instead of working from memory. But that's okay. I think we can lighten that blue up a little bit. Maybe a little titanium white. Bit more. It's still kind of dark. I think we'll go with this. That's better. That's a very nice shade of blue. Very nice indeed. Of course, I don't know why I'm painting the back of the plane, because it's going to be yellow. This is almost as relaxing as writing. So one thing about these videos is that they take a while. When I'm completely finished with this plane, I'm gonna chop up the video and make a condensed version of this, start to finish. But for now, just enjoy the painting. And I will have to go back and touch up a lot of areas that I will inevitably miss because of all the camera equipment in front of my face. It's kind of hard to see. Imagine this video would be a good sleep aid. I've got some other model kits that I was thinking about starting. One is a custom van. I was thinking about building that kit, making it look like a van straight out of the 70s with shag carpet and all that cool stuff that people put inside the van back then. Some of you are probably too young to even know what I'm talking about. But back in the 70s, it wasn't uncommon to take just an old van and put a bed and carpet and a refrigerator and a sink. You weren't really turning it into a camper, but more as a just a rolling bedroom, pretty much. I've got a book with a lot of pictures of these vans in it. I'm sure the book has probably been out of print for many years. But I thought it would be a fun kit to build. Especially if I can figure out how to replicate the shag carpet. People used to put some pretty wild paint jobs on their custom vans. You might be able to do a YouTube search for custom van and see exactly what I'm talking about. I also have a Camaro model kit that I would like to build sometime. Hard to get up in some of these tight areas of this airplane. This blue is still a little darker than the prototype, but that's okay. I'm not gonna punish myself because it's not perfect. It never was meant to be perfect. I hope all the sounds are being picked up by their microphone. Every time I think I have it covered, I see another spot. It's a very nice blue. It's very nice indeed. Get under this wing. did I miss? Building these models. It's very, very, very peaceful. And we can all use a little bit of peace in our life. It's a crazy world that we live in. And maybe that's the solution, is for everybody to take up a hobby. And bring some peace into their life. Well, I think I just spotted a place. If I can get to it. Right on top of the wheel. On this, I don't know if it's a bomb or an external fuel tank. Maybe one of you plane experts can tell me. I think it's a fuel tank. it and get the front edge of the wing. Disc. I've been shooting my Minolta X700 camera a lot these past couple of weeks. For some reason, every time fall rolls around, I get the old cameras out. I've been shooting black and white film. ISO 800. I'll show you some of those pictures later on. Okay, it's time for some yellow paint. Let me put this down. Forgot to close the top. Okay, in the next video, we'll do some yellow.